Hello guys, Skullgrim here, bringing you another Desktop Dungeons video. I have a strategy planned and I'm just going to play Naga City because I've been doing that a lot lately. I think it's a lot of fun. Here we go. So, I'm going to be a tinker. An orc, I guess. The reason I'm going to be a tinker is because of his extra shops, increasing the chance of getting a item soon as you're going. So you can get prep one item, but you can't prep two items, so it's going to increase the likelihood of that happening. And then there's a good pick on the first floor of this dungeon. So I'm looking for the whurgarbl. Whurgarbl combined with Amadeus Codex and Knockback. Could have gone for the Bear Mason and some other god, but Knockback and whurgarbl and Avatar's Codex, it's pretty insane, I imagine. Now, he already has a ton of these, but if I'm not gonna have problems with the costs, because things are cheaper and you already have a stealing potion and you already have two of these, so let's get even one more of this and you have to fill out inventory with good items. Okay, so here he is. Pick up that. Whurgarbl. Booyah! Amazing. That is very good. Might want to pick up the whiteboard, because it's gonna make him a really, really good region fighter when I have this thing going here. So this is something that would stop me from being quite as good a region fighter. So I'm thinking of getting that, and this would make me an even better region fighter. And they're both small items, and they're both fairly cheap. So, this could be fun. I'm wondering if my burn stacks max if I hit things, even if I don't have the burn rats in my inventory. I'm not quite sure. I can even get this now. They're all small items, and that is really cool. Okay, I'm gonna try and boost myself up to being able to take on level 2s, and that will be not this one, at least not yet. So yeah, push him into, it's not a wall there. How about down here? Yeah, that didn't do much. Okay, that's a wall. That's not okay. A bit unlucky here. Okay, let's see how to push him. I have knockback. Don't want to be poisoned though. It's kind of annoying this. Just do something like this. Or not. Gosh darn it. Yeah, this is what it is right now. Okay, let's. I could have used these. I could definitely have used these to make this a bit more efficient. Piety lights. Well, I will be able to reach the sub-dungeons just using Pissorf's and Enemy's Wall here, so I don't really need to save them up for opening up to this. I imagine. Okay, so I'm probably going to go straight for this. Right, I do believe so. Really? That kind of sucks. Fifteen out, and that means I need to find 20 walls. And level twos, it's just not possible right now. One of these is actually the NPC that brings me to the second floor, because essentially he is a floor. Deal too much damage. I can get resistances, that's gonna make me able to tank one hit, but if you look at their HP as well, it's not really looking too good for me. I need to convert things to be able to deal the higher damage, to be able to do higher fights now, and there's nothing that I really want to convert yet. Yeah, you can be inefficient in the first floor here, because there's no bosses, no really hard enemies here, so it doesn't really matter all that much, unless it hurts your strength for the second dungeon. That's how I think about this. Really? I guess so. Not liking this too much. Not gonna lie. Seems to be like a wall here, so it doesn't really help if I push it this way. Yeah, this is prepping bin lore, it's making this sort of hard. I've been really unlucky with the layout, I guess. And I kinda wanna say this, just in case these dungeon floors happen to be really awkwardly placed for preserve. No, let's just screw it. Let's just open up this portion right here and have some fun. Oh, man. You guys. Okay, I got a ton of bite now. Let's find. Okay, that's good. That's done. That feels nice. Next one is 10 walls, but it's just 2 walls unbuilt so far. So let's have a look at this. And it's that guy. Okay, good to know. Really deal that much damage, not. That's gonna hurt me by casting. I can only cast it once. Like, I might be missing out something here. Take away his overheal. Right here, I have enough room for them, they're cheap. Should probably just go right ahead and do it. At least this one. There we go. Tempted to get this one as well. 18. Semi-pricey, but I'll get it. Okay, I'll just push this guy in. Which costs 3 wall per click, which means that I probably want to use it once or twice. That means a bit more unveiling of walls. Oh, nice. Like that. There, I guess. Okay, let's just do that. Yes, the burn stacks maxes without even picking up. Seeing it there. Might not make it. Yeah, not making it. Did I even do this before? I don't think I did. Which is silly if I didn't. Probably want to hit him first because I'm gonna put burn stacks on him, and yeah, it's fine. What? I thought I said I was gonna win. Gonna have to look at the replay for that. Alright. Okay, I am able to take out level 2s now, so I maybe be able to take out this guy. The problem is, he does magical damage, and that makes this not help out as much. Can pre-cast a sidestep before the fight, that would make me able to take one more hit, but yeah, I can do, yeah, because I'm gonna take the burn stacks twice from Pissorf, hit him, Pissorf, hit him, Pissorf, and then that's gonna make that just work. So a bit wasteful here now. 8 is all I need because I'm gonna be able to kill him by doing that, yes. I think so. And it didn't calculate correctly this time either, so there's something about the knockback burn stack thingies that's not calculated correctly, I guess. I'm kind of just using the Avada's Codex for the burn stacks and the physical attacks instead of using it for the actual improved burner at strength. Interesting, I guess. I haven't boosted my health, so that's usually when this is really powerful, I feel. Because now it actually deals quite a lot of damage to myself by doing that, so I'll just try this. Be a typical Piss Orf Orc knockback thingy. Can I get level 4s now? That would be fun, but no. So level 3s it is, and that's not you. Not without getting injured, no. Plate mail. Oh, that's interesting. Probably not gonna be slowed though. Well, I can be slowly if I do the piss offs at the end. That could actually work really well because I'm gonna hit things a lot of times and stack burn stacks and things. So could be a thing. Is there no walls here? Nope, there's not a wall in sight, so do this then. I'm gonna have to use this probably. enemies everywhere. I am gonna be able to one-shot things because I'm an orc, so I'm probably gonna get high damage at some point to be able to kill things. One hit, popcorn, but right now it's looking a bit bad. So if I'm gonna level up, I'm not gonna level up by doing this, so I can't actually use this if I had the chance, and I will be getting the chance now. There we go. Let's try. Nice. Do I need to use... I probably should have done this before I started the fight, I see now. Do I need... Yes, I need to use my thingy. Possible to sort of 18 damage minus just a bunch of percentage there. Try my luck. So let's just do that once because why not? And then, yeah. Okay, fine, that's my choice, I do believe. Starting to really want to have end as well now. Which is fairly expensive and I'm gonna level up soon, so... Not without problems. Enemies in every single place you can imagine. Rock art, cheap, and I'm gonna crush walls. But you know, inventory space is sort of becoming an issue here. Sort of. I probably shouldn't waste it. I think this guy's gonna become a total beast at the end of the dungeon if he just can get there and try and make something out of this, get extra experience from the monsters. So I need to be able to do that to be able to make the most of things here. And without converting things and getting extra damage, well, this is extra damage right there. It's gonna make it hard, yeah. And I'm just gonna do this now. There's this one, and that's the exploding signpost. Lovely. That's a compression seal, and the schadenfreude now, isn't it? I think it is. Compression seal, nice. I like. Okay, so who's next? Not you. Not you, but who? I mean, this does damage a lot more now, but still not amazing. I can work around physical resists by knocking things into the other things, but I can take two hits. Yeah, I'm gonna be able to kill this Gorgon. But I need to be able to click this and also be able to level up. So that means a lot more bitey than I have right now. And let me push this guy. That even gives me the might. Yeah, perfect. Lovely. I like that. Oh, of course, I meet a vampire. Okay, there's blacksmith down there. So, minus 15 equals, I have 7, that means I need even more. That's this guy then. Perfect. I might actually be able to pull this off without using my death protection, which would make me able to kill level 5, really, at this point, 5 Gorgon. But let's just let's do it this way. Oh yeah, to be able to pull this off, I would have to do what exactly? Stone skin is not, don't have enough piety to get stone skin level up. And there's 27 damage, that's more life than I have. I can't use this twice, I wouldn't even kill him. So let's see now how much more of a 5 that puts me up to 22. Okay, let's just try it. 1 square. That's the 3 there. That's 1 there. And okay, that worked. That worked. So I could do a level 5 or even maybe even a level 6 Gorgon. And 49 damage. I think I'm able to tank that if I do the stone skin. He won't poison me, so how much does the items I can get help me out with the fights actually here? Yeah, the rock heart is really good for me right now. So I'm gonna get the rock heart, I think. It's a big item, isn't it? That sucks for me. And it's not so helpful on the second floor. It's a good thing just to convert as well, because it costs so little and it gives so much. That alone seems like a grand choice. Yeah. And go for level 6 serpents. Why not? Why not? There is. So, need to get my piety up first. And here we go. Oh, nice. If I can get some more, that will be great. Stacked up a bunch of piety now, so I don't need to worry about that too much. Okay. I definitely see the problem with filling my inventory. I can actually use the compression seal and then pick up the other compression seal here. Yeah. Okay, it's fine. So if I can knock 2 enemies, that will make 2 mites and 2 heals from during a fight. I see 1 boom or boom, but I don't see a second place to knock somebody into something here. Yeah, this guy. Okay. Fine. Don't survive that, but if I do this, then I do survive it. Easily. Survive that, and then I do this. And then I do this again. Yeah. And it deals 6 extra damage now because of the burn stacks. I need to be careful about not thinking it does too much damage. Now the thing is, do I go for the healing and try and go for another? No, I can't. I need to to get more piety before killing that guy, because he's gonna level me up. Did take that, and that's good. Can kill him, because this is not gonna work. If I'm gonna kill him anyway, I might as well just waste my, or not waste, but use my mana on getting some piety. Don't want to heal this Gorgon, because that's going to heal him, and that's going to heal him too much, I think. I can use one piss off on him and one piss off on the Gorgon, that works. If I can use two on getting piety, that will be preferable. Well. Okay, I got it for free. Awesome. Yeah, don't want to push it, don't want to heal one more, because that might actually set things pretty bad for me. This is the one, didn't even see that one. And I'm kind of tempted to go for this, you know, but where's that going to put me by the ways? So we have 8, I mean 2 more, and only 3 more squares. Yeah, I don't want to do it, I'm just going to kill him now. There we go. There we go. I want to carry the piss off with me all the time, like on the second floor, or is it just valuable here? Because I'm thinking about what I need to compress here. Well, we'll see. I do imagine this serpent being sort of killable if I could hit him into something, but I can't, so he's not the one. He's just not the one that's gonna kill him, and I don't wanna kill him because I wanna knock him multiple times into things. Weaken is not my cup of tea here. Yeah, fighting magical enemies is the way to go now at this point. Just one up higher. If I could find a level 6 or 7, that would be appropriate. Piercing wand. Oh yeah, I got it for free. Let me see. Yeah, I'm not gonna use it. I'm just gonna convert it because I really need to get my extra damage. I know it has its usage on this floor and the second floor as well, but don't have room for it, mate. Just gonna get him out of the way and have a look here, and yeah, okay. Oh, this guy does that to me. I don't want him to do that. If I can kill him in one hit, that will be appropriate. At the same time, I need to get reach this, so. thing, you filthy thing, you. Yep, I am gonna get the Ender Scroll. That's just how that goes. Gold. Not really like I needed it, but oh well. And I did the thing I said I wasn't going to do. I should have compressed things and then picked up the compression seal there, but the compression seal is a small item, so there's ways to get rid of this. And get, yeah. Okay. So I got them both of these, and I got this, and I don't need to use this, so it's just about using this now. Try and maximize the magic assists before heading to the next one. As well as trying to maximize the experience I get from the enemies here, so. Yep. I click it once, get some more, and get the physical resistance up. Might as well, I guess. Okay. What about? Yeah, that's another one I'm just gonna convert, I do believe. Yeah, because I'm gonna get so much benefit from getting this extra damage. I think this is just an easy fight. Would be a lot easier if I could knock him into something, but I can't. I can also always push this guy there. And that will get me started on this fight, but I might. Might I be able to win this fight? With the combination of everything I have going for me, I think I will. So just kill a level 8, a level 4. Ooh, Fireheart. Yeah, I'm gonna use a lot of pieces, but I don't have a big mana bar. That's, and it will have a big health bar, which this thing likes because it's percentage based heal and it's per cast, doesn't matter how much it costs, just times cast. So, not gonna get it. Would have been sort of nice to have both the hearts getting my health up really fast, but I don't think so. If I get enough room for it, I can get it. But I don't see it happening right now. Okay, need more piety before starting this fight, so I'm gonna just do this, I guess. Oh, nice. There we go. That's one. Okay, let's evaluate this. There's one wall there, and there's probably a wall there. That could mean good things for me. Mm-hmm. Could mean very good things, actually. Let's see, let's open up this as well, just in case, and let's just explore this. And we get to see exactly what we have in store. That's one. And if I just push him now, I'm gonna get my health up. Still not enough to be able to tank it, but it's gonna get there now. Alright, and he doesn't die. Okay, I don't want to use my death protection if I can avoid it. This isn't a wall. I have might already. If I push him this way, destroy this wall, well that's... The thing I could do is, if I had this, I could finish him off with using that. But I don't have enough room for it now. And I don't want to lose this. This seems like the thing to get rid of. Which is kind of a bad idea because of how ridiculous... Actually, the enemy that deals a lot of damage is actually a magical enemy, and I have a lot of magical resistances, so I think I'm gonna get rid of it now. And suddenly, he is actually going to die, isn't he? Let's evaluate here again. How close am I? I'm 80 off. Yeah. Yep, I didn't think about the burst attacks. You can just push someone and that's gonna make the burst attacks take off, isn't it? It needs to hit something probably. So two enemies like here. Oops. Marvelous. Okay, so I'm starting to hit like the powerful stage on this guy. Soul Orb as well as having the Viper Ward. Yeah, because that's just gonna let this guy just hit things time after time. I'm liking it a lot. I'm gonna kill this guy. How do we do it? Well, I knock him into... I think that's this guy, because I wanna go around his physical resists by knocking somebody into him. I'll put him there. And now we're ready for the party. I need a lot of piety again. We're running out of piety, but we're doing the highest level enemies here anyway, so it's worth it. I'm actually gonna get 60 now, even before clicking the stone skin. Okay, so yeah, stone skin doesn't help versus this guy. Damn it. So I can hit him twice. Let's see, let's just see here now. Yes, Dragon Soul. Thank you so much. Okay, so death protections are out of the question now. But I already killed a level 9, level 5, so I might not need death protection for the level. Lines for the future. This guy is almost dead. I knocked him into the wrong guy. This is a really, really bad idea. Problem with this is that you don't see how much you damage the second guy. It's kind of annoying. Oh, I guess I'll just kill him because why not? And don't see anyone else level 9, just level 8. Sell this guy, but don't want to hit him at all. So I'm gonna go for this guy then. Physical resist is gonna make this hard, but burn stacks is gonna, well, what burn stacks? Yeah, I am wanting this pretty badly right now, but I have full HP and MP, I mean HP, which is what I lose from going on this, so should want to lose my HP before doing that. Well, I'll probably try myself out here by doing this, then this-ish. Just gonna destroy this wall. Go down here again. I am actually able to do that, but let's just do this. It's not a wall, is it? Doesn't seem like it. And a lot sucks. So let's do this. And this, and that's pretty close. Need to have enough to level up, right? Yeah, leveling up. So I'm doing this. Oops, it AC. Yep. Okay. Keep forgetting that does a little more than it says. So we're let's see how this it's not gonna work. So level 8, where are you? No more level 8. Okay. Okay, there it is. Knocking these two into each other and then level up during a fight or something. I don't see any other way of doing this right now. Because I really don't want to be corroded over weekend if I can avoid it. This is like the slowest game ever. I'm so sorry. Dragon Soul didn't help me out much there. At all. I'm gonna lose my might, but not a concern really. There might actually be a popcorn that I could just take out with that because of the might, and I can't take out one hit now. Should probably have scouted for that one first. Getting slightly worried that this is not gonna work. Could probably have knocked somebody into some, or maybe not, there's not that many walls left actually, so that might be a thing. I need to maximize my piety to be able to maximize my end game magic resists, and there are a couple walls down here as well, so you know, once I kill these two then there's no reason for me to use mana on the enemies anymore, just on the walls to get piety. So I think it'll be just bloody magnificent, to be honest. Okay, this is like level up material right here, and now I'm gonna be able to finally do this. Okay, pick it up. I'm gonna pick up that one as well. Just leave it there for now. Boom. Let's compress something. Let's compress the BMAs. Because why not? And I need more piety to be able to level up. Yeah, might not even be able to level up this floor now, I think. Maybe just barely, I don't know. Is there something I can convert to increase my damage to make this work on this level? These are not. I want to bring everything with me. This is a small item. Choices, man. Choices. Dragon Soul. Nope. He's just not gonna fly. Okay, oh yeah, two small items. That's the solar band, the venom dagger. I think I am gonna go for those. I can afford both of them actually, so. Look at this. Wow. And I could still afford, you know, taking away a week and whatever. Probably should just take a level a week and then just be satisfied with that. Yeah, let's just do it. I can pick up this, and I can do what exactly here? Hopefully it's not to cost. Oh, it did. And then, actually, if I level up, then I'm going to be able to take him out in one hit without taking the damage and the corrosion. But leveling up now, it's getting hard. So he's probably going to be able to heal up. So there we go. Oh, really? Well, that's unfortunate. Look at all that gold. I am going to be able to purchase bloody everything. Just wow. Okay, knock things into the capacity here is, well, I can do this always. Let's get some more black space by you. Doing that as well. Space would be this two there. Cool. One. As well as healing while doing this as well. That's really cool. Nice. Not so nice. Yeah, I'm gonna be able to purchase and remove the corrosion. So I'm just gonna step into the puddles and it's just gonna be not a problem. Right? Right. Okay. Shotable, nice. This guy's not one shotable, but will I be able to make him one shotable by doing something like this? and how much is that really worth to me compared to just getting a lot of piety from Bindler? Well, just one more. Wasteful. Piss off. So it's 43. And I don't want to click it now because it might remove as well. It's actually removing the closest ones, and that is not the closest one. These are. Exactly. So, boom. Fair enough for me. And there's no more black space I can get to reach here by crushing, so just crush this wall because why not? And I said I was gonna I can do this one more time because I'm gonna crush walls and I go down this second floor. $70 here. Pick up the potions and got three of those and I don't want to have that, and I have a lot of gold, so that makes it really easy for me just to step on all those just in case there's any hidden corrosion. There is not. And then we'll go to the shop and get this one. 1 weekend is not a problem. Okay. So, make a choice. I can purchase this and get the mana potions. Sure, let's do that. It costs 20. It's the most expensive item here, so if I'm gonna steal something, that is what I'm gonna steal. Obviously, I can steal something downstairs. There's the ammo general, which is really expensive, and that would be a good choice, you know. Okay, how much do I need? I need 20 gold to reach a second god. I'm happy with this amount of resists from Bindler, so I'm joining Mystera because I need to be a bit more of a caster as well. I just think that will work out just fine. So I had 20 left, and I have 20 left after doing this, so let's use this plate mail combined with burner ass with this codex. It's taken very little amount of damage, but it does mean that my inventory space is gonna be filled. Rock hearts, I don't think I am actually gonna keep it, so I'm gonna try with those items. 30 conversion points. Oh yeah, this one as well. Decisions. I don't think that it makes up for a bunch of small items. I don't think it does. I don't need this gold. Like, I really don't need to have this much gold. But it makes me able to do some funky things with Tiki Tuki. Let's just be silly now. I was supposed to steal from the Ender, but oh well, I stole that one instead. Okay, so oh shit, I forgot about this. I'm gonna be able to get 50 really quickly. Oh, I didn't mean to stand there, but okay, so I am immune to both his things and he deals magical attack, which makes this guy the perfect target to hit into all the people. Don't wanna be cursed either, so it seems like the way to go. this is just 34. Don't want to level up before leaving and joining Mr. Just a second, guys. I'm just going to do something quick here. There we go. Okay. So before I start this fight, I might as well do what exactly? I'm going to finish off by doing this. Or should I actually start by doing that? Well, I can do one. Another one. Or just straight up kill him like that. Really strong strategy. Okay, he curses me and I don't want to be cursed. Because that takes away my dead damage reductions. As well as potential physical assists. So I'm gonna knock Frank into him. Yes, I am. I should be using this backspace and not this backspace because this refills, this doesn't. Really, really non-optimal play there. Okay. Time to join Mistero. Get one of those. Some more of that. And it's soon time to get that again. Hit him. And like this, hit him again. And take it off again. Or rather, heal up a bit more. Yeah, I need. Let's see. Four 30, and this is yeah, a lot more. And I'm gonna heal by doing this as well, so that's just nice. Keeps going places I don't want him to stand, and it's really frustrating. Nice. Slowly but surely, he is dying. Is this enough? Almost. But almost doesn't count in this game. But I can kill something else and that's going to take his burn stack, so if that's, see, that's going to level me up and that's not a problem. It's actually pretty great right now. Pretty great right now, yeah. He curses me, I don't care. Should finish him off by doing this, so I'll hit him once. Let's see, if I want to hit him, I should do this first. And then, let's just be sure that it works. Oh, I heal him up, damn it. Well, I have might, so it's, yeah. Or did I even heal him up? Never mind. He is dead at least. Okay. Level 10. Play of metal does 20 damage reduction, and I should have done this, or maybe I should have gone for this. Well, who cares? This is actually going to be more expensive with the mystic balance, so maybe not. Maybe I did just the right thing actually. Okay, there's a ton of damage because I'm cursed, so don't be cursed. That suddenly the other guys deal more damage because they don't deal magical. but still does a lot of damage. So I'm knocking him into him, and like, this guy's the hardest one, so I should probably knock the Super Meat Man into Lord Gob actually. So I'll just do it like this, because he is the easiest target for me to kill as well, because of how I'm built. He's poisoned, so this doesn't matter. How much is off is it? It's getting there. Actually getting there, yeah. Nice. And he's just about dead as well. Oh yeah, this way. If I can get it for free, then that would be great. I didn't. So he's 87 HP right now. 59. And yeah, he's healing by doing that, so I shouldn't be doing it. Yeah, Brenda, this kills him, so I'll just do that. This is going to refill anyway, but the rest is not. So yeah, he is tough. He is one tough bastard. Goddamn alarm. Yeah, I'm running a bit on overtime. Okay, so is he tough enough for me to have to use the shops? Probably not. I'll level up during the fight, and I think that's just gonna do it. He healed up somehow. Huh. Okay. That's gonna curse me, but I'm gonna be able to kill things. Oh, two enemies actually. Well, fuck it. That's one. Missing balance or magic? I don't know. Let's remove the curse, shall we? Stack up some of this while I'm okay. He's got the physical assists, he's got the magic assists. Just gonna beast them down, I think. Something along these lines. Not really thinking too much now, just going right ahead. I'm feeling a bit too cocky maybe. Okay, let's just stop for a moment, I think. Knocking him into him, that's a no-brainer, but apart from that, I'll heal up. And I think I'll just straight up win if I can do some of this. Some, yeah, there's a bunch of blacksmiths there. So double click and kill myself. Downside to not hitting him is I don't put the burn stacks on him, and I don't poison him, which is like a big deal. gonna do that as well. 20 burn attacks, you know, it's a lot. It's a lot of damage. So I don't know. Not entirely sure here what we're going for, but I think whatever I'm doing is working. This tower of goo is a lot harder than the snake. It was like 40 damage something that it didn't count for there. Like, where the hell does that come from, you know? Okay, I'm gonna do something funky, I think. Take it to okay just to get some golds going. Because it's just like easy. It's getting pretty easy, yeah. Let's reach this. And let's try and win without having to use potions. That would be cool. I would like that a lot. So 5, 5 is 10, 43, 46, and these guys are easy targets as well. We get them there. So if I join him, I can get extra experience, and I can also get poison and dodge and everything. So I'm gonna pay myself into his. There's gold, and I'm gonna pay him. There's more gold. I got 20, and I paid 20 to get in and paid. Yeah, it's fine. Now I'm gonna lose a lot by hitting things multiple times, but I'm also gonna get a lot from just. Oh, they actually damaged me. How is that? Oh yeah, the plate mail. Ooh, that's really bad. Yeah, but I reduce their damage as well, wouldn't I? Huh. I can't hit him, so let's just level up. And now I'm able to hit him. Actually able to get this as well. Is he going to give me more piety? And for what it's worth, I'm going to be able to poison a bit more. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to hit him one more time by getting, but might be able to make me hit him. Kill him with extra damage. So here we go. Yep, that's enough. And we're at the boss. I could just pay a ton and, you know, get this. But there's no reason. I'm just gonna kill him anyway. Easily. Let's just prep ourselves. The enemy won't disappear, and you'll just so that's how I win the Naga City with the Tinker, whurgarbl with that average codex and playing really slowly and thinking about all these energies, I guess, too much. Really overkill, you know, didn't use potions, have a lot of gold, shouldn't really have been using this much time. Oh look, huge, huge event log. Yeah, so 68 minutes. Sorry if anyone bothered to watch this. thanks for watching, bye guys.